Hello, I am Marcel Sweetering and I'm professor of food microbiology at Wageningen University and member of the ICMSF since 2005. In this clip, I will explain a new type of sampling plan, a mixed three-class plan. There are different types of sampling plans. We have qualitative and quantitative tests. In a qualitative test, we use enrichments to detect culturable cells in a sample. In a quantitative test, the number of cells present is counted. We also do have two- and three-class sampling plans, and we can use them as food safety criterion or as process hygiene criteria. In this clip, I will focus on three-class mixed plans. This plan has a lower level small m and as a qualitative limit, and a presence-absence test. The upper level, big M, is a quantitative limit. The ICMSF sampling plan tool has a tab two-class enrichment for two-class qualitative criteria. It has two-class counts for two-class quantitative criteria. It has three-class counts for three-class quantitative criteria and three-class mixed for the three-class plan with a lower qualitative limit and a higher quantitative limit. Here, the three-class mixed tab needs to be chosen. In a three-class mixed plan, the lower limit of the three classes is a presence-absence test, for example, absence in 25 grams. The upper limit is a quantitative test, for example, 100 CFU per gram. This plan detects a high prevalence, since then more than one of the enrichments will be positive. It also can detect a low prevalent, high concentration by testing if an occasional positive sample is larger than 100 CFU per gram. This table is an example of a three-class mixed plan. To test for the small M limit, 5 samples need to be taken and enriched, and only one is allowed to be positive. For the big M, that positive sample should also be counted to determine if the concentration is above 100 CFU per gram, since in an enrichment we only know that there is at least one culturable cell, but it could also be 10 or 100 or 1000 or even a million. They all result in a positive in an enrichment. We could look at the performance of different Listeria plans, and you see here several in this table, expressed as the arithmetic mean concentration. The first is the most stringent, the EU criterion for foods for infants and for special medical purpose, with N equals 10. Then the Codex and EU criterion for foods that do support the growth of Listeria, with N equals 5. In the US, zero tolerance is strived for, but often only one or two samples are taken. Then the last one is the most lenient criterion, the Codex and EU criterion for foods that do not support the growth of Listeria. You can see that the performance difference between the most lenient and the most stringent is a factor of 14,000, and between the no growth and the growth, a factor of 4,400. If we add now in this table the three-class mixed plan, we can see that it comes close to the EU Codex criterion, and it's stricter than the N equals 1 or N equals 2 criteria. This plan can detect an occasional positive, so 1 out of the 5, with a low concentration, without being rejected. This table might be a good try for you to test if you can operate the ICMSF tool. Try to reproduce all the numbers in the, of this performance, and when you manage, you are really a certified ICMSF spreadsheet pilot. Congratulations! Here you see the ICMSF spreadsheet for a specific three-class mixed plan, indicating also the performance of 0.32 CFU per gram. But back to the plan. Now, not concerning the performance, but how to perform this plan, how to operate this. One way could be to homogenize 25.1 gram or milliliter of food product and 225.9 milliliter primary enrichment fluid, and then enrich 250 milliliters of this and plate 1 milliliter. Normally you do that then on a big agar plate or divide it over 3 normal plates. This should be done 5 times in parallel. The enrichments have to be done separately, and compositing is not allowed, since we have to find out if 0 or 1 or if more than one enrichments are positive. The same for the quantification. Every specific sample of the 5 should be 100 CFU per gram or below, so 10 or below on every plate. Another possibility is to freeze the 1 milliliter samples and only plate that sample if one of the enrichments is positive. This saves time and material, since in most cases all of the 5 samples will be negative and further testing is not necessary, since then the criterion is complied with anyway. This approach also saves time and material when more than one sample is positive, since then the criterion is surpassed anyway. But it costs more time in case exactly one enrichment is positive. 3-class mixed plan have as lower limit, small m, a presence-absence test to evaluate low prevalence. Furthermore, they have a quantitative upper limit, big M, that can identify presence of high concentrations. In this manner, the plan can detect both prevalent low-level concentrations and also less frequent high-level concentrations, with both should be prevented.